Hello and welcome back to our plumbing course. I'm Joe Carswell, and this lesson covers iron pipe. So let's get right into it. Okay. Welcome to our channel. By now, we've loaded almost 100 videos onto YouTube so that anyone can have access to structured trades training resources. We are really trying to grow this channel, and the best way for that to happen is for you, the viewer, to subscribe. Also, if you learned something from these videos, don't forget to click like. So thanks for your support. Let's get back into the lesson. We're going to cover a couple different types of iron pipe, black iron and galvanized steel pipe. We're also going to go over the fittings and some installation materials. Let's start with our different types of pipe. I have our galvanized steel pipe here and a black iron pipe here. The systems work very similar. We put them together the same. The fittings are very similar, but their purpose is completely different. We will use our galvanized steel pipe for water supply lines, and we will use our black iron pipe for propane or natural gas lines. A plumber also runs pipe for gas. When we're working with iron pipe, one of the real advantages to this system is it's super rigid and all the connections are super strong. So let's get into some of the details of each different type of pipe. Starting with our galvanized pipe, this one has a silver look to it. The reason it's silver is because it is coated with zinc, and zinc keeps the steel pipe from corroding. And a rust in a water line is a very bad thing. So we don't use this pipe as much as we used to. It is sort of an old-fashioned plumbing system. These pipes will have fittings that are also galvanized, and there are threads on the ends of the pipe. These are external threads or male threads, and we will have female threads on the fittings. We will screw these together to run our lines. Our other type of pipe, black iron, is used for propane and gas lines. It's black in appearance, and it has the same threaded connections on the ends. This pipe is not zinc plated or zinc coated. That would cause corrosion when you mix in that propane or natural gas, which can cause failures at the fittings and corrosion on the inside of the pipe. So this pipe is very black. This is more what I'm used to as far as black iron. This is raw steel pipe, and this one's been painted, which I'm a little surprised about. This is much more common to see, and this is literally just raw steel. So it is greasy, it has some oils on it to keep it from corroding, but other than that, black iron pipe is sort of a simpler version of our galvanized pipe. We're combining these two types of pipe in one lesson. They work for different purposes altogether, but the way we assemble all this system is exactly the same. So it makes sense to kind of talk about them in the same conversation. Remember though, you would never combine these two different pipe materials in one plumbing system. The galvanized is for water supply and the black iron is for a gas installation. Our pipe comes in different sizes. We have our common sizes being 1/2 inch, 3/4, and we even have a 1-inch pipe. Of course, with any plumbing system, these pipes can get bigger or smaller, but these are the most common ones that you'll see in both types. Like our other plumbing pipes, we size these pipes based on the inside diameter of them. So we can assume that if this is a 1/2-inch pipe, the inside of this pipe would be 1/2 inch. We can compare this to some other materials like this copper tubing, which is measured from its outside diameter. And you can see that the inside diameter of our iron pipe is exactly the same size as the outside diameter of our copper, same as with our PEX. So just remember, when we're talking about pipe, we're working with an inside diameter when we're sizing the pipe, and with our tubing, we're always working with an outside diameter of the pipe. That makes our pipe seem a lot bigger and it makes it a lot stronger. This is a great time to talk about our threads when we're plumbing. And if you understand your threads with iron pipe, this will translate into a lot of different plumbing systems because these threads are standard. We call these NPT threads. These are our standard threads, and any NPT threads will work in any other NPT threads as long as you get the sizing right. So these threads are tapered, and what that means is when we screw this into a fitting, it will become tighter the farther we screw it in. And by screwing that in tighter, we get a rigid connection and it helps seal the pipe. So if you see in the illustration, it sort of exaggerates this condition. And this is what makes this system work so well and become so strong. Now that we've gone over our pipe, let's talk about our fittings. If we have rigid pipe, we can run it in straight lines. We need fittings to change directions and run our path. This is a half inch female threaded end cap, and this is my male threads on my half inch pipe. I can screw that on and it will seal off the end of that pipe. It might be that you need to make a straight connection between two pipes. You would do that with a coupler. This coupler has female threads on both ends and it will wind right onto this pipe, and then it's ready for another pipe on this end. So a straight line, that's an easy part. Let's turn a corner. I'll do that with a 90 degree elbow. That's this fitting right here. One pipe goes in this side, one pipe comes in this side, and now that's my 90 degrees. Maybe you don't need 90 degrees. You can do 45 degrees. I have a fitting for that. This is my 45 degree fitting, and that's half of my 90. And that's what this looks like. A T fitting is a different style. And a T will take a straight line and we can run a pipe off of that, or a branch off of that. That would look something like this. And we call it a T because that's what it looks like. It might be that you need to change pipe size in a run of pipe. You can do that with a reducer. This is a black iron reducer and it is half inch on this side and it's 3/4 on this side. So I can take a half inch pipe, screw it in on this side, and then I can put my 3/4 in over here on this side. So within one fitting, I was able to change my pipe size and reduce it. You can also make a reduction in pipe size within another type of fitting or the same fitting. This is a T, and this T is a 3/4 on this side, a 3/4 on this side, and it reduces down to a half inch coming out of this branch line right here. So our half inch pipe can come out of this end, and then I have my 3/4 that works out of either side here. And this is a common thing we do when we're plumbing, to run our main line through. That's a larger pipe and we can reduce to a smaller size for our branches. Another way to reduce a pipe size would be with a bushing. This is an insert that you would put into any fitting and it will size down that pipe to whatever size the bushing is. In this case, it's a 3/4 pipe that reduces down to a half inch. So you have on the inside of the bushing, you have female threads, and on the outside of the bushing, you have male threads. A union is a critical fitting when we're working with iron pipe. What a union allows us to do is to connect or disconnect these pipes without having to worry about this threading situation that happens at every connection. So this is a union, and it's actually three parts. I'll show that to you. But this is a half inch union. It would be a half inch pipe on either side. And now when I screw these pipes in, I have them in a straight line, but now I can disconnect these pipes without loosening either one of these threaded connections. That's by twisting this collar here. So as I twist this collar, it will release or disconnect these two pipes. And what I have here is two mating surfaces that connect and seal together. So when I push those back together and I twist this collar on, we can reconnect this and seal it up again. This is a really critical fitting if you have maintenance that you need to do, say on a water heater, or you work yourself into a situation where you can't thread or connect the threads and the fittings properly. You can put a union in and it will make the whole system work. Let's look at some valves. We need valves for our plumbing. Starting with a ball valve, this is a half inch ball valve. It's threaded on both sides. We can thread our pipe in, and this will give us control over the flow of water through our pipe. In its current position, this ball valve is off. Remember that perpendicular to the line is completely off. If we turn it 90 degrees or parallel to the pipe, that gives us full flow on. Let's take a look inside of this and hopefully give you a better idea of how a ball valve works. So there is a ball inside of this valve that has a hole in it. Right now that hole is lined up with the valve and the pipe. We've got full flow. As I turn that handle, it's going to close or move that opening in that ball out of the way. Now we have a completely closed or shut off situation. Once again, look at it this way. If I turn it slow, you can probably see that hole lining up. And as I turn it this way, it's closing, closing, closing. That should be fully closed. That's a ball valve. Another kind of valve you can use in this system is a gate valve. A gate valve works different than a ball valve because it has a door or a gate in it. And as you open or turn the handle counterclockwise, that gate lifts up, right? So as I tighten or turn this handle clockwise several directions, that gate is slowly closing. And we can push that or turn that all the way down so it's completely shut. And I can't really see it. It should be getting close. It takes a lot of turns to get there. Once again, this is a control valve. It will allow us to control the flow of water. Very important in our pipes, threaded on both sides. This is a three-quarter valve. So you might have seen in some of the earlier footage, a pipe with some white stuff wrapped around the end. This is Teflon tape. This is pipe installation material. This helps us seal the pipes. I did that for demonstration so you can kind of see this sealant material already installed on the pipe threads. We do this for a couple of reasons, but let's take a close look at this material. This is my pipe or Teflon tape, and it is very thin tape made of Teflon. Feels like plastic. It's not sticky, so it's not really tape. It tears very easily, so we don't need any tools to work with it. But it, when wrapped around the threads, will seal all of those tiny gaps between the male and female threads and give us that sealed connection. Another material we can use to seal threads is pipe sealant. You might hear this called pipe dope. This is a really small container of it. Most of the time, you'll see it in a much larger container. But this has the consistency of toothpaste. This is a white version. It has Teflon in it. It actually has some fibers in it too that help seal. You might see this in a gray color as well, but it is it will be placed on the threads, and when those threads are screwed together, this paste will help seal that connection too. Some plumbers use both their pipe sealant and Teflon tape together on their connections. So there you have it. This is the basics about working with iron pipe. Your takeaway from this should be in the threads. All of that information about threads will carry over into a lot of different plumbing materials and processes. And remember that these threads are standard and we can work with other materials and threads as well. So thanks for hanging in there for another plumbing materials lesson. Keep in mind, this is what we do before we get to do the fun stuff. That's putting all of this together. So I'll see you in the next one.
These threads are tapered, or hold it on the end. There you go. These threads are tapered.
These threads are tapered.